Reading has opened humanity to a lot of different ways of absorbing information about our environment. It has allowed humans to explore the past, present, and future, ideas that have and will change the world, and share our experiences. One of the most important jobs that parents and educators have is to help students develop reading as a habit. There are instances where children are unable to read print in the normal way. Dyslexia is a learning disability which hinders a person's ability to process, understand and read fluently, even though they possess a normal IQ. There are three main types of reading. The traditional form, eye reading, is considered the most common type of reading. This involves making sense of the text by analyzing word patterns with the eyes. The information is then interpreted and processed in the brain, leading to what we can refer to as comprehension. The other two types of reading, which are ear reading and finger reading, need to be incorporated into the methods by which educators teach students. Let's jump right into the three types of reading in detail. Eye reading makes up about 90% of what we may generally refer to as the standard reading method. This is because this is the normal way most people are taught and learn. This type of reading captures words, sentences, and phrases with the eyes in order to create meaning. This forms the foundation for most reading done by the majority and ultimately comprehension. Eye reading will always remain a key component of reading and it must always be taught to students in order to help them develop fluency, phonemic awareness, and decoding skills as early as the elementary level. On the other hand, there are many children who are unable to decode text and have not been fortunate enough to get the right intervention that they need. This is where ear reading comes in. Ear reading becomes essentially where eye reading has not proven very effective for children with reading disabilities. Students that cannot process text print on a page but are able to comprehend to a certain level, they can still do most of their reading with their ears. Ear reading is sometimes disregarded as an effective type of reading or considered not true reading. For many children who lack phonological and decoding skills needed to interpret text fluently, especially children who are dyslexic, ear reading becomes very necessary. Technology has made life a lot easier for parents and educators and most important children who are dyslexic. Finger reading allows the blind to interact with words using their fingers. It is easy to assume that Braille isn't a form of reading, but you are really not going to point that out to a blind student. Similarly, you aren't going to say to a dyslexic student that ear reading isn't actually reading. It is a fantastic type of reading for learners and adults who cannot process text the normal way.